Okay, good morning students. We are going to discuss chapter 3, weather and climate. Today I have started this class with homework. Few terms I have given, you have to find out their meaning and have to write in your copy. And second question, two differences between weather and climate. So there are four terms I have given: weather, climate, meteorology and meteorologist. So out of these four, I am going to say first two because these two are our chapter's heading, weather and climate, and completely new for you. So first, what is weather? Weather actually the state of atmosphere, or you can say the condition of atmosphere over a short period of time on a small area. Means it's a state of atmosphere over a short period. Means today's weather, morning weather and night weather. Today one type of, okay, I am explaining one second. Weather varies from morning to night. Sometimes we can see that morning heavy rain takes place and evening there is a no rain. Means weather has changed. That's why in the definition I said over a short period of time. Means it can change within a very small duration and on a small area. Means the weather of Maithan, today's weather of Maithan and weather of Asansol or weather of Dhanbad, not same. Varies. That's why I said on a small area. So weather means a very specific way, state of atmosphere for a short duration over a small area. And the climate, that one we can use in a broad sense. Climate means the weather conditions, but average weather conditions for a given location over relatively long period of time, like climate of India. We cannot say that weather of India. We say climate of India. Means what is the climate of India? It is the weather condition, average weather condition, but about a big area, large area and for long time. Long time means how much? Like 30 to 35 years. I repeat, 30 to 35 years weather report together form the climate of a large area. Means meteorologists, they keep per day weather report. We are getting that report through newspaper, radio, television, per day weather report. So like that way whole year they keep the record, they maintain the record. So like that way we are getting year 1, year 2, year 3. This way after 35 years we will get one average weather condition. Condition of what? Condition of a large area like India, which is called climate. And the ultimate result is, all of you know what is the climate of India. You know that December, January means winter, May means April, May means summer, June, July means rainy. So this is the climate of our country. Actually this climate is the average weather condition for a long period of time. So weather means state of atmosphere. Here climate means state of atmosphere, but state of atmosphere means average condition of atmosphere. Weather related to small area, climate related to large area. Weather can change within short duration, morning, night, evening, any time. But climate remain unchanged for long time, like 30 to 35 years. Done? Now one word I said many times, state of atmosphere, condition of atmosphere. What is the meaning state of atmosphere? State of atmosphere or condition of atmosphere or elements of atmosphere means this seven I have mentioned here. So elements of weather or elements of climate, whatever you can say, that is the same, because climate means average weather condition. So it is same, elements are same. So these are the state of atmosphere. Now, these are the elements of atmosphere, and they are temperature, precipitation, humidity, atmospheric pressure, wind speed, wind direction, and clouds. So these are the seven elements. So these are the seven elements which represent the state of atmosphere, and we express it with the term of weather. So weather means these are the, we have to know about the state of these elements. We have to know the condition of these elements for a short duration on a small area. And climate means same thing we will know, but for a long time over a large area. So to know this state of, or to know these conditions, or to know the elements of weather, meteorologists use some specific instrument and they express it with the help of some specific unit. First, we have to know the name of all elements, all instruments and all units. So I have done this table here. All of you write this table, and this table also I want to see in your copy. So one by one I repeat. Our first element is temperature. It is recorded by, or it is measured by, 6 maximum and minimum thermometers. Today I have written short form. You write the full one. Maximum and minimum. 6 maximum and minimum thermometer. And they can express with the help of two units. Degree centigrade, degree Fahrenheit. Okay. In degree centigrade, boiling point, all of you know 100 degree centigrade, and freezing point 0 degree centigrade. And in for degree Fahrenheit, boiling point 212 degree Fahrenheit, and freezing point 32 degree Fahrenheit. So they use these units to express the temperature of atmosphere, and they can record the temperature with the help of this instrument. Next one, precipitation. Short one I have written, PPT. It can be many types. Two important one I have mentioned, rainfall and snowfall. So this rainfall or snowfall can be measured with the help of rain gauge, and they can express it with the help of these two units, millimeter and centimeter. In book, millibar given, it's a printing mistake, student. You change that one. Millimeter. Millimeter means when we are showing, when they are showing, not we are, meteorologists, showing the monthly rainfall figure. And centimeter they use when they show annual figure. Okay. Next one, humidity. You know what is the meaning of humidity. Presence of water vapor in atmosphere. Humidity means the water vapor, the amount of water vapor which is present in the atmosphere, which can be measured by this instrument, hygrometer. Okay. And they can express it to different units. One is actually absolute humid, I have written short form, and here they use gram. And next humidity is relative humidity. That one they can express with the help of percentage. And out of these two type humidity, absolute and relative, relative one is more appropriate and applicable. Means meteorologists use relative humidity. Meteorologists find out or give us the information about relative humidity with the help of percentage. Next, atmospheric pressure, air pressure, which can be measured by barometer. And it can be expressed by millibar, in short MB. Wind. Wind actually two different way we can measure the wind. One is speed, another is direction. Speed can be measured by anemometer. And the unit we can use kilometer per hour and meter or meter per second. And wind direction can be measured by wind vane. Wind, and this direction doesn't have any unit. Actually, wind direction we can measure by wind vane, and then we can give some name of the wind. Otherwise, all of you know, wind doesn't have any name. Still, to recognize them, we can call them like southwest wind, northwest wind, southeast wind. How? With the help of direction. So here they don't use any unit. With the help of direction, we can identify the winds. And the clouds, instrument not given, actually they use a big mirror, very big mirror, which is divided into some blocks on the, and that how many blocks are there, it depends on the calculation. So the specific name is not there, only unit name is there, that is octa. to express the cloud, they use this unit octave. So all of you write this table. Then one by one I will explain. So student, this is the table. It shows all the elements of weather, and these elements can be measured by these instruments, instruments name, and this can be expressed with the help of this unit. So this table I want to see in your copy. So now I am going to discuss each element one by one. But before that, once again I want to repeat what is weather and climate. Weather is a state of atmosphere over a small area for a small duration or short duration of time. And climate, it is the average condition of weather over a large area for a long period of time. And state of atmosphere means we are talking about the elements of atmosphere, and these are the seven elements which I am going to discuss now. I am going to start from last, cloud. Cloud is measured by one particular instrument. I said it's a mirror type of instrument, but name not given, but it can be expressed by octa unit. Now I am going to say one important role of cloud. Okay, see this diagram. Roughly I have done, sun gives us heat but cloud is present, means it is cloudy day. So less heat we are getting, our surface gets less heat because cloud absorbs this heat. So daytime our surface is cool. So that means, I think many of you, all of you have seen, the cloudy day means cool, weather is cool, not very warm or hot. Why? Because cloud already absorb heat. Now if we talk about the night, suppose cloud is also present, what happened? Surface also releases heat. Can you see the arrow? Surface also releases heat, but this heat cannot escape. Why cloud is present? That's why. Now surface time, sorry, night time surface is warm. So finally what we can see, that night time if cloud is present, then we can feel warm condition, and daytime if cloud is present, we can feel cool conditions. So this is one of the role of cloud. Now wind speed and direction. Instrument's name I have mentioned. Speed can be measured by anemometer, direction can be measured by wind, and unit also I have written. But one thing I want to say about the wind. Wind basically, student, two types I have written. Can you see? Warm wind and cold wind. See, this is our earth. Can you see the 0 degree area? It is called equator, and 90 degree north south, it is pole. You know equator means hot area, or you can say hottest area, because sun gives direct sun rays here. And pole means, you know, they are covered by ice, means very cold and getting slanting sun rays. So what happened when wind blows from, can you see the broken line, equator towards poles, that wind is called warm wind. And if you see the wind is blowing from polar area to equator, that is called cold wind. That means wind mainly two types, warm and cold. It depends from which direction it is coming. If it comes from equatorial area, by nature it is warm. If it comes from polar area, by nature it is cold. So whatever the nature can be measured by these two instruments. And two more types we have, two more types of wind, which is called sea beach and land beach. Very simple diagram I have drawn. If wind blows from sea to land, that is sea beach. And if wind blows from land to sea, that is called land beach. But these bridges are formed due to this atmospheric pressure, changes of pressure system, atmospheric pressure system. That one I will discuss. Now you just keep in your mind that wind also two types. We are getting these two types of wind, land beach and sea beach, where? In the coastal areas. Specific area, which area? Coastal area. Coastal area means where land and sea they meet. There we are getting this sea beach and land beach, and their speed also measured by anemometer. But how are they form, that one I will discuss later. So wind mainly two types, warm and cold, but in a particular area, coastal area, we are getting two more types of wind, that is sea beach and land beach. Okay, our next element, number 4, atmospheric pressure, which can be measured by barometer. Barometer actually old instrument, modern one is called aneroid barometer, and it can be expressed with the help of millibar unit. Now this pressure varies. Students, all of you know that pressure is less in top of mountain, but it is very high where? On plain area. But we cannot feel the pressure, we cannot feel the air pressure. Why? Because of our internal blood pressure. But it is very high where? On sea level, which I said plain area, near the sea level. There it is 1032 millibar. But if you go upwards, pressure continuously decreasing. And due to this changing pressure system, we are getting sea beach and land beach, which is the important part I am going to explain. Just now I had shown, I explained that when wind blows from sea to land, sea bridge, land to sea, land bridge. And you see, all short form I have written here, I am telling you, but just opposite way I have written. This one sea bridge, so this one land bridge. This is day, this is night. So it is clear, daytime land bridge is blowing, daytime sea bridge is blowing, nighttime land bridge is blowing. Okay, now here sea, here land, but over sea we can see high pressure, here we can see low pressure during day, and here surface is cool, here surface is warm, and just opposite situation we can see at night. This one sea, this one land, but here low pressure means on the sea, and on the land high pressure during night. And here now it is in warm situation, sea, surface of sea, and here surface of land is cool. How is it possible or why? Now I am explaining. So now I am going to say why this opposite situation developed during day and night. See, sun gives us heat, all of you know, and that heat our surface can absorb, plus water also can absorb. But water takes time to absorb the heat. But land is the solid mass, so it very quickly absorbs the heat and convert it into a very hot surface. Done? Now think about this diagram. Now see this diagram. This is the daytime, sun gives sun rays. So now this land absorbs heat and convert it very warm surface into a warm surface, and warm surface means low pressure. Yes, student, temperature high means pressure is low. Okay, so here temperature high, warm surface, that's why low pressure develop. And just now I said water takes time, so this surface is still cool, and it is cool, that's why high pressure develop. Done. And we one more important thing, wind always blows from high pressure to low pressure. Wind blows from high pressure to low pressure. So here high pressure develop and here low pressure develop. So wind is blowing from high to low, means sea to land. That's why sea bridge developed during daytime. And just opposite situation we can see night. Night means what happened? This surface means land and sea, they start to release heat. Same thing, it is solid mass, so it can release heat very quickly and convert it into a cool surface nighttime. But sea is still warm because sea takes time. And here it is cool surface means the air above the land where high pressure develops. Just now I said low temperature means high pressure, and high temperature means low pressure, and wind is blowing from high to low. That's why during night time wind is blowing from land to sea, which is called land bridge. So these are the two types of bridges, sea bridge and land bridge, and these bridges develop due to this atmospheric pressure system, which we can see it varies daytime and nighttime, it varies, even it varies over land to sea. Done. Next one is humidity. Humidity means that day I told you the amount of water vapor present in the atmosphere called humidity. So suppose it is one amount of air mass, one cubic air mass. Okay, so here I have written 30 gram means, here I have mentioned absolute humidity can be expressed by gram. So here water vapor amount is 30 gram. Done. But temperature is 40 degree centigrade. Now here I want to say one thing, if temperature increases, water vapor means humidity amount also increases, temperature decreases, vapor quantity decreases. So temperature is 40 degree centigrade, this one cubic air mass holds 30 gram, but here I have written but can hold 50 gram. What is the meaning? This air mass has the capacity to hold 50 gram. I repeat, this air mass can hold 50 gram water vapor when temperature is 40 degree centigrade, but 30 gram is present. Okay, it can hold 50 gram, but present is 30 gram. So it has more capacity, it has the capacity to hold more vapor, but still vapor is not present here. So relative humidity tells us about this ratio, how much is present and how much it can hold. That is the relative humidity. Page number 35, you will get the definition answer I have written. But I am explaining this one, that 30 gram water vapor is present when temperature is 40 degree centigrade, but it can hold 50. So the ratio between these two is called relative humidity, but we have to multiply it with the help of 100. Why? Because I told you it can be expressed by percentage, that's why 100. So ultimately we are getting answer 60%. So this air mass has the humidity now 60%. Now means when temperature is 40 degree centigrade. So its relative humidity is 60%. This is the humidity. So now next one is rainfall. Rainfall is measured by rain gauge. Not only rainfall, snowfall also, these are the two different forms of precipitation, and these two different forms we can measure with the help of rain gauge and can be expressed by millimeter and centimeter. Millimeter means we are showing, meteorology showing the monthly figure, and centimeter means annual figure. Done. So now rain gauge, one instrument, page number 33 in a detail given. What type of instrument? It is a metallic graduated cylinder with a broad base. Okay, and it is placed where? In an open area which is far from the building and trees. Not only open area, it also keep over a level area. Why? Because rain gauge is made up of glass. So they keep this instrument open area, and when rainfall takes place, it comes where? Within that measuring jar, measuring cylinder, and they can collect the rainwater, and finally we are getting the result, the amount of rainfall per day basis, from their monthly basis and from their annual basis. That is the rain gauge. Now this rain gauge instrument, we are getting the amount of rainfall, and that amount of rainfall, that record also help us to form ISO height. What is ISO height? Actually ISO heights are imaginary lines we join the places having equal amount of rainfall. I have done one this diagram, very rough one. Suppose our country India, so many states, so many places are there, different places receive different amount of rainfall. Okay, and now with the help of this line, if you join those same amount, same figure, then we will get these lines. So these lines ultimately, these diagrams ultimately help us to understand why rainfall is less, where rainfall is more. So ISO heights are the imaginary lines. We join the places having equal amount of rainfall. done. And it is it helps us to understand the amount of rainfall throughout a country, you can say, about a big place, whatever. Next one is temperature. Temperature, everything I have written, it is made up, it is measured by this instrument, 6S maximum and minimum thermometer. These two unit we are using, centigrade and freezing, boiling and freezing point varies here, whatever. Now the important thing is isotherm. Isotherm is same like isohite. Here it was the equal amount of rainfall, now equal amount average temperature. Means I repeat this one, that isotherm terms are imaginary line which joins the places having same mean temperature above the sea level. Here same mean temperature, here same amount of rainfall, that is isohite and that is isotherm. One more thing here I didn't mention, instrument name, thermograph. Yes, you will get one more name, thermograph. What is thermograph? Thermograph is a modern instrument. Thermograph is the modern instrument to measure the temperature. Now the important part, Stevenson's screen. What is Stevenson's screen? Actually, Stevenson's screen is a box made up of wood. Okay, so this thermometer, 6S maximum and minimum, measure the heat. But what type of heat? Our body temperature? No. Our surface temperature? No. The temperature which directly comes from sun. That's why meteorologists keep this instrument inside this screen, inside this box. Why? Because it is made up of wood. Wood is not good conductor of heat, all of you know. And it has many slots. Four sides, it is a box, means four sides it has. And there are many slots through which wind can move. And this thermometer can easily measure the heat of that wind, means which is coming from directly sun. Plus this screen has four mounts. Mount means leg, four legs. So with the help of this Stevenson screen, meteorologists keep this thermometer above from the ground. So this thermometer cannot measure the surface temperature also, because it is already above from the ground and within this box. So it can only measure the sun rays directly. That's why Stevenson screen is very important to measure the air temperature, because they should keep this thermometer where? Inside this box. So this is the overall elements of weather. Part of the chapter, that is homework part. Students, already this type of homework I have given at the beginning. Okay, define the following terms and one difference. There were four terms and one difference. Same thing I have given, but four new terms here I have mentioned. Isotherm, isohite, thermograph and relative humidity. So total eight now. Eight terms you have to define, and one more difference I have given, sea beach and land beach. So total two differences. Okay, so this thing you will write in your copy with that table which one already I had shown, elements of weather. And these two questions, one is discuss the following, three boxes are there, page number I have marked. And from exercise question number 7 means if you follow it is true false. Okay, so these two items you will do well in the book directly with the help of pencil, and rest of the thing you will do in your copy. Okay, so now you read the, now you see the videos and mark your doubts, and you can ask me through WhatsApp. Thank you.